As part of a video game, the point 5,2 is rotated counterclockwise about the origin through an angle of 20 degrees. We want to find the new coordinates of the point. So to do this, we're going to sketch a vector with a terminal point of 5,2. Then we'll find the direction and magnitude of this vector. Then we'll rotate the vector 20 degrees counterclockwise, and then find the terminal point of this new vector. So again, we'll start by sketching a vector here in red, where the terminal point is 5,2. We'll find the direction of this vector given by angle theta, as well as the magnitude of this vector. Then we'll increase theta by 20 degrees, then determine the terminal point of the new vector. So again, we first have to find the magnitude of this vector and the direction given by theta. Well, the magnitude of vector u can be equal to the square root of 5 squared plus 2 squared. So the magnitude of u is equal to the square root of 25 plus 4, or 29. Now to determine angle theta, we know tangent theta must equal y divided by x, or in this case, 2 divided by 5. Well, if tangent theta is equal to 2/5, that means that theta is equal to inverse tangent or arctangent of 2/5. And because this trig function value is not one that we find on the unit circle or using reference triangles, we'll have to use the calculator to get a decimal approximation for theta. We do want to make sure that we're in degree mode, so we'll press the mode key. We are in degree mode, so now we'll go back to the home screen, press second tangent 2/5. So theta is approximately 21.8 degrees. Now to find the coordinates of the point that's rotated 20 more degrees counterclockwise, we'll rotate this red vector 20 degrees counterclockwise, and then find the terminal point of the new vector. So if we rotate this red vector 20 degrees counterclockwise, it might look something like this, where the magnitude of this vector would still be the square root of 29, but the direction, which we'll call theta sub 2, would be 21.8 degrees plus 20 more degrees. So theta sub 2 is equal to 21.8 degrees, the direction of the red vector, plus 20 more degrees. So the direction of the rotated vector would be 41.8 degrees. So now if we find the horizontal and vertical components of the black vector, given that we know the magnitude is square root 29 and the direction is 41.8 degrees, we can find the coordinates of the terminal point of this vector, which would be the coordinates of the rotated point. So if we know the magnitude is square root 29 and the direction is 41.8 degrees, we can find the coordinates of the point x and y using these two formulas here. X will be equal to square root 29 times cosine 41.8 degrees, and y is equal to square root 29 times sine 41.8 degrees. So going back to the calculator, x is approximately 4.0. And y is approximately 3.6. So the coordinates of the rotated point are approximately 4.0, comma 3.6. Okay, I hope you found this explanation helpful.